And so to turn blue at 14, you would need to reach a blood oxygen saturation of 83%. That is very low, unlikely to ever happen during a swimming race. However, if you're using EPO or, for example, blood doping, you're using your own blood. Take out a pint of blood from your body a month before the competition, keep it in the fridge, and then add it in the night before the competition. You now have more blood, more hemoglobin. ITPP is included on the World Anti-Doping Agency's prohibited list of substances for human athletes. However, no method yet exists to detect this substance in human urine. Coach Greg, in today's video, the purple faces at the Olympics. What exactly is going on? Well, I'll tell you what's going on. Doping. Oh, it's 2024. No one would ever want to cheat. Are you kidding me? Many people are wondering, why are so many people on the U.S. Olympic team having those bluish purple faces? What exactly is going on with that? It's from this skin condition. This is going on. It's normal. Yeah, in some people it's normal, but why didn't they have it at the last Olympics? And Olympics before that. Why is it that all of a sudden so many people have purple faces, purple bluish skin, and so on? And so recently, WADA releases a statement. USADA scheme in contravention of World Anti-Doping Code. The World Anti-Doping Agency, WADA, responds to a Reuters story of August 7, 2024, exposing a scheme whereby the U.S. Anti-Doping Agency, USADA, allowed athletes who had doped to compete for years in at least one case without ever publishing or sanctioning their anti-doping rule violations in direct contravention to the World Anti-Doping Code and USADA's own rules. And so let me explain what this means. People fail the drug test and they go up to them and say, "Hey, yo, you want to work undercover? You can keep competing. We won't announce your names. Keep winning your championships. And all you have to do is tell us who else is using steroids. Tell us where you're buying your stuff from. Who are the cheaters? We'll expose them. And so you're our undercover agent." And so they let them compete. This is against WADA. You're not allowed to do this, but do you think they care? Do you think each nation follows the rules of the world?
If you've been watching Olympic swimming recently, you've noticed some of the athletes' faces are turning red and even purple at the end of the races. And a lot of people have asked, why is this happening?
Why do you think? Oh, is it something in the water? And oh, it's only happening to athletes in certain countries. Let's put on our thinking apps right now for about 3 seconds. Doping! That'd be like saying, "Hey, why is it that certain women in certain countries, they all sing and sound like Coach Greg? Are they all natural?" No, they're not. None of them are natural.
And why is it only happening to athletes from certain countries?
You need to touch ground. Stop glazing each other's countries thinking, "Oh, they're so amazing." They're not. They're cheating.
This Reddit article right here was even referencing something that I put together about what happens to your body when you swim and chlorine and how it impacts your skin.
If you say it's the chlorine, that's cap.
And it's just your body's way of trying to regulate your body temperature so that you don't overheat. That's why your face appears red.
And so notice he says it turns red and pink. I didn't see anything about turning blue. Now, if you had a little baby girl and her face suddenly started to turn blue, would you not be panicked a little bit? Hey, you're blue in the face. It's not good. Pink from running, swimming, exercise. Hey, these are good things. A lot of oxygenated blood in your face. But when it's turning blue, it's meaning it's getting deoxygenated. And once it gets so deoxygenated, it gets so low, your skin literally turns purple and or blue, and this is not good. Unless you're using drugs, and I'm going to tell you which one it is, and then this can help you win a medal.
Some of the athletes are changing their color at the end of the session, at the end of the race, and they're not doing it because they want to. It's just happening.
And so the reason they're not turning blue everywhere, you're thinking, well, why are their hands a normal color? And it's just the face that's turning blue. The face has a lot more blood vessels and the skin's a lot thinner. In comparison, the thickness of the hands a lot thicker. And so when you use drugs, blood doping, and so on, you're going to see the bluish tinge on the skinnier parts on the face and not on the arms. And so when you see this bluish discoloration on the face, as you can see right now, it's circle on the screen. This is an indication of central cyanosis. That means that the entire oxygenation of the blood, it's gone down. Normally, your blood oxygen saturation is perhaps close to 100%. Maybe it's 98% and so on. But during this race, you're clearly, you're swimming faster than last time. You're holding breath underwater. And so that goes down. But if you're not on drugs, it doesn't go down so much that you're going to turn blue. Now, remember, as you work out, as you exercise, you're holding your breath and so on, your oxygen saturation, it's going to begin to go down. But if you're using drugs, for example, ITPP, or doing blood doping and you have extra hemoglobin, the appearance of this bluish skin is going to happen at a much higher level. And so for one athlete, they're, for example, down to 90%. They're not going to appear blue. But in another athlete at 90%, they are going to appear blue. That is a definite sign they could be using ITPP or they're doing blood doping. And so the normal hemoglobin concentration of a normal athlete, for example, myself, be around 14 grams per deciliter. And so to turn blue at 14, you would need to reach a blood oxygen saturation of 83%. That is very low, unlikely to ever happen during a swimming race. However, if you're using EPO or, for example, blood doping, you're using your own blood. Take out a pint of blood from your body a month before the competition, keep it in the fridge, and then add it in the night before the competition. You now have more blood, more hemoglobin. And so if you do that and your hemoglobin concentration goes up to, for example, 18 grams per deciliter, then you only need to be at 87%. And that is much more likely to occur. And so when you're in the Olympics swimming your hardest, there's a much greater chance you're going to see that bluish color on the face for somebody who's blood doping than somebody who is not. One of the causes of central cyanosis, that bluish purple face, is polycythemia. And the other cause is hemoglobin with low affinity for oxygen. Now remember, ITPP literally causes that. When you take ITPP, of which I've done years ago, used to use this, it was a very painful injection, didn't like it, made me so sore it wasn't worth the pain. What it does is it allows the body to give off more oxygen. The hemoglobin, it has a certain amount of oxygen. And when you use ITPP, it's willing to give off more oxygen. And the more oxygen it gives off, the faster you go, but also the more deoxygenated the blood becomes. And so you get that bluish purple face. Making sense? And so the next time you see your favorite athlete, I don't care who it is, doing the breaststroke, the backstroke, and they finish the race, they're like, yay! And their whole body looks nice and tan with their six packs, but their faces are blue and purple in the face. They're probably not natural. If you watch this Coach Greg video and you go up to these athletes, or you write in the comment section and say, this is what it is, they're going to then say, no, it's because the pool is cold. I was shivering and I turned blue. Don't you know it's from the cold? It's not that. They're going to come up with whatever excuse they want. What's next? I broke that record because I ate chicken, broccoli, and rice 3 times a day, and I swam for 6 hours.
And at the end of the race, you can obviously see the fatigue. You can see the color change.
And remember, there's a big difference between Mike Fenn and Mike Dow, and there's also a bigger difference between pink skin and blue skin. If you're turning blue and purple, that's a big difference than turning pink. If you exercise hard and you had flushing of the face, you're getting warm, that's normal. But when you turn blue and pink, hey, now that's cap. ITPP is included on the World Anti-Doping Agency's prohibited list of substances for human athletes. However, no method yet exists to detect this substance in human urine. If you had two steroids, one of which they knew how to detect and the other they didn't, which steroid would you use? And so when you watch the Olympics and you're thinking, oh, they're all 100% natural, are you sure about that? Some tests have yet to be developed that detect these illegal substances. And even if they did, sometimes countries don't even report the athletes that failed. Oh, you failed the drug test. We're going to let you keep going. Don't tell anyone about it. That's happened in Canada. It's happened in the United States. I know people this happens to. Remember, Coach Greg has been tested for years. Don't you think I know what's going on? What's going on with the faces of the American swim team? All turned Thanos purple while the Chinese swimmers' faces stayed pretty normal. Don't bring up genetics because Tori Husky has Chinese ancestry and other white athletes look perfectly fine.